Hi, this is Emily Iannelli. How are you? I'm just hanging out in my car. I'm gonna do a little karaoke. I guess you could call it car karaoke. Sometimes I need to get out and just hang out in my car and sing. Because sometimes it gets a little noisy in the house, so it's harder to sing. And I just came where I'm still in the parking lot of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, where I attended a baptism and got to hang out with some nice people, friends. And they want me to start thinking about getting baptized as well. So I'm thinking about it, and I like to attend here. People are very nice. They're very kind and caring and accepting. And I feel I found a home here. And we want to be with people that we can appreciate and bond with and feel accepted by. And that's what I found here at the church. I wish that I could get my son to come as well. I think it would be a good experience for him. And I hope that he'll come at some point, because I think it would be a place where he could grow and mature and learn. And, you know, he is going to the Catholic Church, and I was going there as well, but not like my son. He's more church-going, and that's a good thing. But I didn't really benefit. I love what it's about, but there was no social interaction that I find here at the church in Plainview, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And I find it a very helpful place to go. And plus, I have my elder friends that come to my house, and we hang out and do things together. You know, they come and I order in dinner or something, and we read the Book of Mormon, and we learn, and we talk about Jesus and how important he is in our lives. And I just find that it's a great place to come, and it's a great place to be around people and socialize and talk and make friends, you know. And that's what it's all about. And I wish I could get Matthew to come with me some point, dress him up nicely in a suit and tie, and bring him over and have him sit with me in the service, and then introduce him to some of the young people here. And who knows, maybe Matthew could become a missionary and help others too. Obviously, he would be introduced and learn, and then maybe one day he could make contributions to the church as well. So anyway, that's what I like about this church, is because they make me feel welcome, establish friendships, and they also call me and make sure I'm doing well, and they wish me well in my recovery, you know. So I think it's wonderful. Anyway, I'll talk later. Bye. I'm going to do some karaoke. Love you guys.
Tell me about what it's like to be in New York and being away from your family. So, and what's your name, by the way?
My name is Elder England. New York is the greatest place on earth. The pizza here is the best thing I've ever tasted in my life. I haven't been to the city too much, but the city's really fun.
And what do you think of your friend Emily?
Emily is actually a celebrity. She's actually famous. She's actually like the greatest person alive. Yeah, she definitely is. She's definitely like... Definitely the coolest person I've ever met in my life.
How do you talk to your family?
I talk to my family every Monday. A video call. There's a video call at 9:30, but it's 6:30 where I'm from. Before my dad goes to work.
How do you like being in the missionary? How do you like being a missionary?
I actually love being a missionary.
In a few words, what is it like to be committed for 2 years to the church, being far away from your family, and doing something you know that's worthwhile?
Well, it's definitely hard, but it's also very fulfilling. It's very joyful. It's a great thing.
And I'm glad that you you are part of the elders who came into my life and taught me a lot. And I'm glad that you'll be here a little while, because Elder Pitao is leaving. And what do you think about him leaving? Are you sad?
I'm actually really happy. Yeah, I'm just kidding.
Say hi! Elder Pitao!
I'm actually very sad.
You're sad?
I'm actually very sad.
Elder Pitao! How do you feel about going back home?
I don't really feel like I'm going home. Honestly. It hasn't hit me yet.
So are you going to miss us?
I'm going to miss you so much.
I asked Elder England what he thought about his giving 2 years to the missionaries. I mean, to be a missionary. What is your feeling on doing 2 years here? And what was your experiences like? I'm sure you had a wonderful time.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. I think it's been a huge blessing. I think, like, out of everything, I probably benefited the most out of it, to be able to grow closer to God. But to help others on the process has also been a huge blessing.
Very good. Are you sad that your 2 years are coming up, or you got mixed feelings?
I'm actually sad because everyone says, how do you feel going home? I feel like my home is New York, so I'm leaving home.
Oh, you can always come back and visit.
I definitely will.
He gets free flights.
Yeah?
He does. He gets free flights.
So where is your home now? Where do you call home?
New York. New York.
No, but when you go home.
Los Angeles.
California.
California. Here I come. And where do you call home?
Actually,
Oregon.
Actually, Levittown.
Why is that?
He's from Oregon.
Because that's where Emily lives.
No, but really, really, really.
I'm actually from Oregon.
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 Oregon or Oregon?
So actually, we were just talking about this. In Oregon, we say Oregon.
Oregon, like?
Oregon. Like my Oregon. But I don't really care.
Well, I think you guys are awesome. And I'm going to miss you.
You're awesome. Emily, I'm actually staying here.
I know you are. But what am I?
What?
Emily, I think you should come to California with me.
Yeah. So, why don't you interview me for a minute or two?
Hey.
What is your full name?
My birth name or my transgender? My birth name is Edward Donald Ayinelli III.
Oh, Donald.
My birth name is that. My trans name is Emily Denise Ayinelli.
Oh, I see. And Emily, how are you so famous?
I'm not famous. What it is that I've met wonderful people in my life, and I have the privilege of being with you and El Capitan and learning and experiencing life in new ways that I never thought I would. And going to church is an enlightening experience and meeting wonderful people. And by you coming into my life made me realize that friendship is very important. Just like I've met friends from my high school days, 40 years now, and I've met wonderful people. And like I said, I've been introduced to the church back last year in October. And it's been a wonderful experience, and I met wonderful people. So by experiencing that, it makes me very
happy. You guys want to take your orders as well now?
We would actually love to.